Hey guys, it's Nanette with Heart Baby Home. So today we're looking at heart number 33, which is upraised or supraventricular tachycardia. Now, super means above, and ventricular refers to the ventricles. So supraventricular means that it happens above the ventricles or in the atria. Tachycardia, tachy means fast, and cardia means of the heart. So when we're looking at a supraventricular tachycardia, that happens when extra electrical signals cause the atria to beat faster than normal. The ventricles still beat at a normal pace, but the atria are faster than normal. So, and this can either happen because there's an extra spot that is sending out extra electrical signals, or it can happen if the electrical signal, once it's done going through the ventricles, if it somehow finds a way to cross over back into the atria. Take a look at the normal heart. We're just going to go through what happens electrically when there's a heartbeat, and it's actually pretty cool. So in the right atria, it starts where I've labeled P, and it travels across all of the atria and ends up at PQ, and then it travels down to Q, where it splits and it ends up getting to R a little bit faster than it gets to S, and then it goes out to T, and that's where it dissipates, and then it starts over, and that's your heartbeat. So where it's labeled P, P is the sinus node, and that is where the electrical signal starts. Now when it gets the electrical signal, that's what tells it, oh, I need to squeeze, and that pushes the blood out. So it starts the electrical signal, and then when it gets to PQ, that is the atrioventricular node. And that's really cool because it allows the electrical charge to pause, which gives time for the blood to squeeze out into the ventricles. So after it's done pausing, then it travels down to Q, which is the bundle of His, and that's where it splits into the right and left. And it reaches R before it reaches S, so your left ventricle pumps first, and then your right ventricle pumps after. And they're really close together, but that's how it does it. And then T, that's when the electrical charge dissipates, and so that's when your ventricles relax. So next time you go look at an EKG, and it has all these squiggly lines, and you're like, what the heck is this? Well, now you know. Because P is where the electrical charge starts, and then Q, or PQ, I didn't label that, but it's between P and Q where the line is flat. That's where it's pausing so that the blood can get into the ventricles. And then Q is where it splits at the bundle of His. R, left ventricle is squeezing. S, right ventricle is squeezing. And then T is where the electrical charge is dissipating and the ventricles relax, and then it starts over. So now let's take a look at our SVT. If you look in the right atrium, there are two places that are labeled P. You've got your normal sinus node, and then you've got another grouping that thinks it's a sinus node when really it's not. And so both of those will send out electrical charges. And the one that's not supposed to be there, a lot of times it'll send out random electrical charges or faster than it's supposed to. And so every time those electrical charges are sent out, then your atria will squeeze. And so it squeezes faster than it's supposed to. That's the tachycardia. And then when it gets to the PQ, again, it pauses and everything else happens normally. So the ventricles don't beat faster, just the atria beat faster. And if you look at our cute little squiggly lines on the P, you can see that it looks just a little bit different because there's two there. And then the other looks the same, but it happens closer together because it's faster. Now, when you're getting an SVT, you don't have time to get all of your blood down into the ventricles, and so a lot of times you'll get dizzy or faint, have shortness of breath, and that's one of the things that they can use to say, hey, we need to go check this out, and then they'll hook you up to the EKG. Now, the way that they treat this is kind of cool. The first thing they do is they'll have you do physical things. And I don't remember exactly what these are, but it'll be something like, you know, cough and stand on your head, or like hold your breath and try to breathe through your nose, or jump on one foot. I mean, it's not those things specifically. Your doctor would be able to tell you. But physical things are the first thing that they do to help you get rid of the SVT. Then they would also look at medicines. I know they do beta blockers and a couple other meds that try to get your atria, your electrical signal, the way it should be. And another thing they do, which I think is really cool, but it's kind of at the end because it's a medical procedure. You go into the cath lab and they thread a catheter up one of your blood vessels into your heart, and then the technology is really good. They can find exactly where that extra sinus node-like grouping is, and they can heat up or cool down. They either use hot or cold to damage those cells, and then your heart heals, but scar tissue does not conduct electrical current, and so it can no longer send electrical currents out to your atria because it can't get past the scar tissue. So that's another cool way that they can help people who have tachycardias. And I've also included a link so I didn't do an animation because there's lots of animations out there that show it really well, but I did find one that I really like, so I'll include that link below. If you liked this video, please subscribe to my channel, and if you have any questions or you would like me to draw you a new heart, please contact me at heartbabyhome.com/contact. I'm also on Facebook, Twitter, and Pinterest. Thank you.